Hello everyone, today we are going to see this topic, male sterility, in that transgenic male sterility. Transgenic male sterility is a genetic engineering based genetic male sterile system which interferes with the normal development of anther and pollen. So in case of transgenic male sterile plants, a transgene is present, that is inserted, which is active in the male reproductive organ that disturbs the normal development of tapetum, filament, anther wall, etc. Whereas in case of restorer plant, another transgene is present which inhibits the action of the other disruptive gene. That is, in short, it interferes with the transgene which causes male sterility. So this was first given by Mariani and his lab mates during 1990 and 1992 and has successfully demonstrated this transgenic male sterile system in rapeseed and tobacco. This system is also popularly known as Barnes and Bastard system. Now coming to the genetics of Barnes and Bastard, we must be very clear about what is Barnes and Bastard. Here Barnes is a chimeric dominant RNase gene. Chimeric in the sense, the genes that are formed through the combination of portions of two or more coding sequences which are obtained from different sources. RNA is the enzyme that degrades the RNA. This gene Barnes is obtained from the bacterium Bacillus amyloliquefaciens. This is derived by a tapetum specific promoter TA29 derived from tobacco. This TA29 is responsible for the specific expression of Barnes in the anther tapetal cells. So, their mode of expression is a selective destruction of tapetal cell layer around the pollen sac, which is responsible for creating the male sterility. So, due to the action of Barnes, the male sterile plants show reduction in the length of the stamen and filament, petal size, bud diameter, tapetal cell content, and the sterile anther carries an empty exome. Now, Bastard, it is a Barnes-specific RNase inhibitor which is isolated from the same bacterium Bacillus amyloliquefaciens, which is responsible for fertility restoration. When this Barnes and Bastard crossed with each other, in the F1, both the genes are expressed, that is co-expression of both the genes. So, by the formation of tapetal cell-specific Barnes-Bastard protein complexes, which is completely inactivate the Barnes enzyme, helps in the fertility restoration process. So, while maintaining this methodology, we must be very sure that the amount of Bastard must be equal or greater than that of the Barnes to eliminate the cytotoxic effect of Barnes in the tapetal cells. Now coming to the drawback, during the maintenance of the male sterile line or during the production of hybrid seeds, the female row, that is a male sterile line, is segregated in the ratio 1:1, and a complete homozygosity of Barnes cannot be achieved since it is hemizygous in nature. As we all know, homozygous in the sense alleles are same, in the heterozygous alleles are different, but in the hemizygous condition only a single copy is present in the natural diploid organism. So in order to overcome all these drawbacks, different strategies has been followed. The first strategy is that the Barnes gene is linked with the dominant herbicide resistant gene called the BAR. For a broad spectrum herbicide known as phosphinothriazine. This BAR gene is put under the control of a constitutive promoter called CAMV35S, that is cauliflower mosaic virus. This promoter is unregulated and it facilitates a continuous transcription of its associated gene. So the BAR gene gets expressed itself from the seedling stage. So now the seedlings are sprayed with the Bastard, that is phosphinothriazine. Then you could see that all the male sterile plants are survived and the male fertile plants are killed since they lack the BAR gene, which helps in maintaining the male sterile plant. So by using this BAR gene, it assures a 100% pure hybrid seed production. So So for maintenance of A line, here for maintaining A line, we use A line and a B line. This B line is isogenic to the A line except for the fertility or sterility gene and resistant to herbicide. So when A line and B line are crossed with each other, F1 segregates in the ratio 1:1. Okay. A line consists of a Barnase gene linked with Bar gene, and the expression of these gene is facilitated by a concerned promoter. While it segregates in 1:1 ratio, two genetically different types of seeds on the flowers of male sterile plants are obtained. From the segregant, the male sterile line, that is A line, could be maintained by spraying the herbicide, which kills all the male fertile plants. Hybrid seed production. Here, a male sterile line are crossed with a male fertile line, which is having a male fertility gene in the homozygous condition, bar star bar and bar star bar. So it is called as a restorer line, and the male sterile is a A line. In F1, two genetically diverse seeds are formed in this diagram on the left hand side. The progeny is having both the Barnase and bar star, making it fertile. On the other hand side, we can see only the bar star combination, making it also fertile. It is important to incorporate the bar gene in the restorer line, as it ensures that the F1 progenies are not susceptible to herbicide application, especially phosphonthriazine. Hence, the farmers can go for herbicide application without any restriction. Yet another difference involved in the system is that the R line should be genetically diverse and must show high specific combining ability with A line, which is essential to exploit the heterosis in the hybrid seed program. Whereas the B line is an isogenic line to A except for those two genes, one is for fertility and other is for herbicide resistance. Advantages: Barnase bar star system does not depend on the natural source of male sterility, and thus any genotype can be converted into male sterile line in case of Barnase bar star system, whereas genetic male sterility is crop genotype dependent. Then male sterile plants are not killed. This male fertile plants are killed at the seedling stage by using the herbicide in case of Barnase bar star system, and specific congenital conditions are not required in case of Barnase bar star system, whereas in TGMS and PGMS, specific environmental conditions are required, and the hybrid seeds that are produced by Barnase bar star system are more pure than the genetic male sterile approaches. Next, coming to limitations, there is a reversion of fertility from male sterile plants. Then 50% of the population is lost, so double amount of female parent seeds is needed for hybrid seed production. This becomes a major drawback in crops with low multiplication factor like wheat. The seeds of hybrid produced or having a transgene, that is a Barnase, bar star and bar genes. So it becomes a big challenge for the release in their public domain due to their ethical, social, environmental and biological issues. Thank you.